These semicircles in the dirt might not look like much, but they have the power to re-green entire landscapes and bring back lost ecosystems. The Maasai community is already using this technique with amazing results, turning this into this. We wanted to find out how it works and went into the heart of Kenya to help return life to a landscape that was thought to be lost. We're Planet Wild. Welcome to Mission 20. Did you know that 60% of all species on Earth live here? It may just look like dirt, but soil is one of the most essential building blocks of healthy ecosystems, hosting countless organisms, recycling nutrients, storing water, providing minerals, and keeping the planet cool by stashing away 80% of all carbon on land. But right now, the world's soil is in crisis. One third of it is already degraded, and scientists estimate this number could rise to 90% by 2050 if nothing is done. Luckily, one of the most effective solutions is surprisingly simple. We sent Rishala from Planet Wild to a Maasai community in Kenya to learn about a genius way to restore degraded soil in a place where it's most needed.
Southeastern Kenya has some of the most incredible wildlife in all of Africa. This area, just a few kilometers from Mount Kilimanjaro, is known as the Land of the Giants. It's home to large herds of elephants, lions, and rhinos, and serves as a critical wildlife corridor. It's here that members of the Maasai tribe and their ancestors have acted as stewards of these lands for hundreds of years, raising cattle in harmony with the environment and wildlife and preserving the ecosystem. The landscape here is naturally hot and dry, but with rising temperatures, droughts are now getting longer than they used to, and rains are becoming less reliable. Huge portions of land are reaching a tipping point where they dry up so much that they lose the very ability to absorb water, even when there is rain. A vicious cycle. It may be a bit counterintuitive, but hot, dry soil like this is really, really bad at soaking up water. That's because the top forms a hard, impenetrable layer. What's more, if the soil microbes die, wax-like substances build up, causing the soil to become hydrophobic, meaning that it actively repels water. You can get a sense of just how hydrophobic the soil is by measuring how long it takes for a single glass of water to be absorbed. These cracks in the landscape show when rain has washed over it instead of being absorbed into the ground. And when this happens, it washes away even more nutrients and what little vegetation is left. The Maasai, whose livelihoods depend on healthy soils, have recognized the need to adapt to the changing climate. And it all starts with water. As the water dries up, so does their primary source of income. Cattle can't be kept, families can't be fed, and people leave. The Maasai way of life, their culture, traditions, and custodianship over these lands could be lost. So if we want to restore the land, we need to restore the soil's ability to absorb and retain water. And we're meeting with the people who have perfected a genius way of doing just that. Just Dig It has been restoring land in Africa for the last 15 years. As an international organization, they are working closely with the local Maasai here in Kenya to help them reclaim their lost land.
It all starts with a semicircular pit called a bund. It's designed to control the flow of water. Globally, farmers have been using water bunds before to help grow crops, but conservationists have realized that they have the power to regreen entire ecosystems. And the best part, you don't need expensive technology, meaning this method can be replicated across the world.
Okay, I'm an absolute novice when it comes to building a bund, but I do know it's more than just digging a hole. So I asked Frida from Just Dig It to give me a lesson.
Frida is the landscape coordinator for this area. She works closely with the community to coordinate restoration efforts on the ground, which are all locally managed and implemented.
Here's how you do it according to the experts. Step one, get your tools. Step two,
measure.
We use a string and a level to identify the natural slope of the land, then position the bunds at the bottom of it, with the mound at the base to collect rainwater. Each bund is then shaped along a precise 5-meter diameter, leading to its iconic shape.
We love calling them earth smiles because when you see them from above, they are just like smiles all over the place.
But first, some sweat is needed.
And that brings us to step 3. Dig!
Can we take a break now?
And we're done!
You are not done.
To kickstart the recovery process, we're adding some native grass seeds and temporarily covering them with thorny branches to protect from curious wildlife.
Ah! Very thorny. Now we're done.
Even as a novice digger, I was able to complete one earth smile in just about 1 hour. It's tiring, but fast and effective. It's incredible to think about how in just a few months, it will go from this to this. A tiny plot of restored biodiversity. Now we just have to repeat the process. A lot.
And that is where our community comes in. We partnered with Just Dig It and the local Maasai community to provide the funding needed to add 8,000 bunds covering a 100 hectares area. A massive undertaking that will retain 2 billion liters of water over the next 20 years. The funding pays for 2 years of salaries for local staff, covering project management, community training, and long-term monitoring, as well as all the equipment and logistics needed.
The energy level here is amazing. We're more than 100 diggers, and each one is motivated and energized to be here. It's incredible to imagine that just in a few weeks, there'll be thousands of bunds.
Once the digging and seeding is done, a beautiful chain reaction happens. Rain collects inside thousands of slopes, allowing the dry soil to slowly soak up the water again. Seeds sprout and drive their roots deep into the hardened earth, breaking it up bit by bit and restoring its original sponginess. Meanwhile, myriads of life forms start to flourish again, providing the nutrients for above-ground vegetation to spread, which then protects the land from erosion and provides shade that lowers the surface temperature and increases humidity. Within just 4 years, the soil and the ecosystem can be fully restored. The transformation is so amazing that we can even see it from space.
But the most mind-blowing thing about the bunds is that they have the potential to change the weather.
During photosynthesis, plants release water into the air, which provides a cooling effect. Other particles also get released, and on a large enough scale, Just Dig It predicts that their bunds could even help create clouds and increase rain.
So right now, bunds are helping landscapes to adapt to less water. But in the future, they may improve climatic conditions to support more life. Just under a year ago, this landscape was devoid of life. But now, the soil is teeming with nutrients, moisture, and up to 40,000 different microorganisms.
When we came here, the vegetation was around 0.1%, and now it has improved to almost over 40%. And we hope for a 70% in the next season.
Grasses, native perennials, animals, big and small, have all started to come back.
As the grass grows, the number of animals increases. So many happy animals in the bund site.
And one and happy feeder too.
Yes.
And of course, it's not only the wildlife that benefits, but the community too.
The Maasai communities have become champions for bund restoration, and more communities are adopting these very simple techniques through living in harmony with their land and also through sustainable land use and grazing.
It still amazes me to see that so much is possible when we apply the right tools and methods. But the one thing that I have learned through 20 rewilding missions so far is that for any problem we're facing, there is a solution somewhere. We founded Planet Wild to highlight and support the best of them. If you're wondering how you can help restore our planet, consider joining Planet Wild as a backer with the QR code over here or by clicking the link in the description below or by asking your employer to pay for it. That's right, because we're now offering a team membership as well. So if you think your boss would love that, or if you are the boss yourself, click the second link in the description below and help us make this world a little wilder.